To speak Jabari Morgan. I've come to speak on peace, which is my new favorite word. To hear. After hearing peace comes resistance in most people. You hear peace and then you feel resistance. Well, it takes time to turn that so that you feel something completely different when you hear the word peace. I'm turning it. Your warring thoughts, thoughts you have that are the equivalent of war, are a source of power. But it feeds a darkness. So when you have warring, conflicting, negative thoughts, they're strong. They're extremely powerful. But they don't feed anything that's going to serve, oh, your higher purpose. A sameness is what warring thoughts provide. A sameness. And I think that's a dangerous word. Why would you want to stay the same? Vistas? Heights? Peace? That's what brings the truly new. This cycle of negativity and judgment that pervade this community has served to push me further away from it and to de-unify something that needs to be unified if it's going to be respected. The cycle of negativity and judgment brings nothing new. The faces may change, but not the name. And the name is same, 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 same. You cannot feel peace and fear at the same time. Fact. And it is very difficult to feel peace, I know that. I know that. I don't feel it most of the time. But I have learned that it is more possible to control your emotions than you might think. And in order to demonstrate this to you, I will ask you, rather, to do an exercise that I did. It takes only a minute, about a minute. And an exercise brought to me by Gabriel and Kate. So here it is, if you will. I want you to close your eyes. I want you to close your eyes. And I want you to think about, or the exercise wants you, I'm using the word I too much, close your eyes. Think about someone you like. Just someone you like, yeah. Good, good job, Jack. It could be your mother. It's probably not me, but it could be. Just think of someone you like. Just like. Open your eyes. All right. So notice and remember where you felt what you felt. You were frowning, which was strange, so. I hope it was. Okay, good, okay, good. All right, now close your eyes again. And think of someone that you do not like. And notice where you're feeling what you're feeling. And what those emotions are like. Okay, now open your eyes. And the final step of this exercise, for me, was the most profound. Close your eyes again, and turn the corners of your mouth up until you're smiling. And notice the instant wave of warmth and happiness that follows that simple act of smiling. Good. Now you know how much control you have. The ripple
And we can open our eyes.
The ripple is also a fact. What's that?
I'm like, can we open our eyes?
Oh, yeah, open your eyes. Sorry. The ripple. The ripple is also a fact.
Yeah.
Everything I think ripples out into this universe because that's the way it's structured. Everything you think does not affect just you. It goes out of you and into the universe. So what are you thinking about? The ripple is real. The ripple speaks to oneness. So start slow. Start slow. You can't confine your negativity and throw it away. That's not possible. So that's only going to lead to you judging yourself for what you lack, which you should stop doing. So start slow. Maybe start like this. Why don't you just gently notice, for the record, how often you're hard on yourself, or how often you're hard on others. Just notice it, that's all. Don't attempt the forcing of your nature into submission, because anger only leads to more anger and fear only leads to more fear. So don't try and deal with that. Instead, simply start by smiling more. Hope. I'm almost done. After a lifetime of pondering the sacred question, how do we live wisely and well, Confucius concluded that of all the crucial elements, it is morality that is supreme. If I had to take one phrase to cover all my teaching, say Confucius, I would say, let there be no evil in your thoughts. So are those evil thoughts about yourself? Or are those evil thoughts about other people? I don't know, they're your thoughts. But I think he's right. Confucius recognized that the person who gradually becomes more ethical unearths a treasure of life, a treasure house of life-altering gifts in the depths of the heart, mind, and soul. These many gifts include, and check this out, what no evil in your thoughts could bring. Reduced anxiety, guilt, and fear. Less cause for worry, defensiveness, and denial. Fewer bouts of self-doubt, depression, and despair. Growing confidence, courage, and strength. Deepening relaxation, calm, and peace. Greater capacity. Notice how these get happier and happier. Greater capacity for openness, honesty, and intimacy. A sense of integrity, trust, and wholeness. Relationships of closeness, consideration, and care. Emotions of happiness, joy, and delight. A heart that is more open, kind, and loving, and a mind that is more open, sensitive, and awake. In the words of the Buddha, speak and act with a pure mind, and happiness will follow you as your shadow. Unshakable. That's what happiness could be. Set your heart on doing good. Do it over and over again, and you will be filled with joy. To conclude, it's interesting that if you look back at the wars that are fought in China, they're not fought over religion. Plenty of wars based on plenty of silly shit. Thank you, Calder, for letting me know this. But those wars weren't based on, if you don't believe what I believe spiritually, you need to be fixed. So they were fought about plenty of, wars were fought for plenty of reasons, but not religion. So try not to be too offended by my bringing spiritual words into this. Existence in and of itself is a spiritual experience. You don't have to reach out and search and grab for God or goddesses or gods or peace or no. You're existing, which means you're spiritual. Before you ask the universe for a sign, as Gabriel pointed out, why don't you just look around you? Because it's probably already there. I see the sadness in your eyes. 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 The solution is connection.
So when you